Good morning, everybody. This is Brother Lloyd, and I hope you're all having a great, wonderful day. Now, what I want to do right quick, and I want to keep it short and simple, is a quick video response to a comment that was made on the video that I did the other day titled The Tree. So, I'm going to jump right in. The comment essentially read like so. It reads, it says, I can see where a person may misinterpret Jeremiah 10 and Isaiah 40. However, these texts are not referring to Christmas trees. Craftsmen who are highly skilled artists carve wood into desired shapes such as animals or people, graven images. Goldsmiths covered the wooden idol with gold and or silver. Those people were worshiping these man-made idols. People today are no more worshiping Christmas trees than they are balloons at a birthday party. Isn't that interesting? To me, that's very interesting. When the enemy takes anything and perverts it, he does it to the satisfaction of man, to our flesh, to our eyes, to our ears, so that we may accept it as not being what it is. So he decorates it, changes and tweaks this, that, and the other, and we accept it as such and say it's not what it is. Now, trees, if you care to do the research, people, and I'm telling you, you're free to do it, trees have been used to crucify people on, i.e. our Savior and many others. Trees have been used to sacrifice people on, winter solstice, Yule logs, all that. Do history, people. It's just too much to sit here and do videos on that stuff over and over and over. Trees have been used, yes, to carve wooden graven images out of, and craftsmen, yes, did cover them with gold and silver and all these things, and people idolize them and worship these idols in their homes and everywhere else. Yes, this is exactly what Jeremiah 10 is talking about. But the Father's word is not so limited in what he's telling us. The tree is not to be idolized because of these things that are and have been done with it. Now, just because the enemy comes along and he says, well, we're going to do this, that, and the other, and we're gonna make it appear just like everything else people accept, because he has created an appearance or perverted the appearance of something that the Father said we shouldn't do, he makes it acceptable to us. So we accept it. So now we take a whole tree, we don't take the branches off of it and carve eyes and feet and all this stuff on it. We just take the whole tree and we drag it into our home and we stand it up and we decorate it and we stand there and we marvel at our tree. Oh, my beautiful tree. And then be not dismayed at the signs of heaven. What do? We put a star right on top and we're worshiping our tree. Now, I'm not going to debate the fact that this comment said that Jeremiah 10 and Isaiah 40 isn't saying the Christmas tree. It's talking about trees. Now, what we choose to do with these trees make it the abomination that they become. If we want to take a tree and drag it in our home and we decorate it with gold and silver, that becomes our graven image. That becomes the idol that we have just made it into. And then we put that star on top and we sit back and we marvel at our trees. Everyone is so competitive. Or just within your own home, you try and outdo yourself every year with your tree. You are worshiping your tree. It's not an argument, it's just a matter of position. Now, if the fact that you would prefer to say, any of you, me, anyone, if we choose to say, oh, well, I'm not carving it into an image or a totem pole and bowing down to it and doing all that, well, that's what you say. But, or the same idea is conveyed when you drag it into your home and you decorate it and then you bow down to your tree, you worship your tree. So I'm going to leave that as a debate that people are going to have with one another and try and defend. But be very careful. The enemy wants us to always say that something is not what it is so that we accept it. It's not a matter of interpreting the Father's word or misinterpreting, because it says what it says. But we have to be willing to open our mind and study and see and let the Father's understanding and discernment really give us clarity on what he's saying to do and not do. With that, I'm going to just kind of leave it as such. Jeremiah 10 and Isaiah 40 is being very specific when it's talking about idols and things that were made from trees. But at the same time, the Father is saying, don't bring this into your home. Don't accept this. Don't do these things with trees, rocks, or whatever the case may be. But don't let the devil convince you that something is not what it is, because he's made it once again beautiful and acceptable. And we want to have what we want to have. We want to accept the tree and say, well, it's not an idol, it's not this, it's not that, when in reality it is. We have to be very careful of what we idolize and worship. People, things, money, stuff, what have you. It's a very thin line, and we as people can cross it all the time and don't give second thought to it. It's no different than Halloween. People understand the history and debauchery and everything behind that, but because people can dress their children up as princesses and wizards and all this stuff. I mean, you're crossing all sorts of other lines of idolatry and worshiping anyway, but because it can be made into quote-unquote fun for the flesh, we accept it and say, well, it's different now. See, people don't want to be told that you can't celebrate Christmas, you can't have a tree in your house, you can't put all these presents under your tree. People get very offended by that, and people get very defensive about that because they don't want to disappoint their children, they don't want to disappoint themselves. They want to have the fun and do the things they do and say it's not what someone else is saying it is. Because it doesn't look like this, it's not that. Look, people, just because you have apples over here and you have oranges over here doesn't mean you can't mix them together. Because people will say, oh, you're mixing apples and oranges. Well, sometimes when you mix apples and oranges, you just get fruit cocktail. This is Brother Lloyd. I'm out.